We want to thank you for coming this evening. We've got a big schedule, one that you're going to enjoy. We're going to sing praises to the King, and I'm sure he's going to bless each one of us. Will you stand with me as we invite the Lord to have his way, to bless us in this service this evening? Our Heavenly Father,
amen.
We're thankful that we are able to gather together with one purpose in mind, and that is to worship you and to give you thanks for the things you have done for us. We truly invite you and welcome you and must have your presence in our midst tonight. And so would you just come, and as we sing praises unto you, will you bless and touch each person that is here, meet their needs, I pray, and may we be able to say, oh, it was good to be in the Lord's house tonight. And we'll thank you for it in thy wonderful name. Amen.
Remain standing, please, okay? A few minutes, okay?
Purple mountains, mountains.
shed his grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea.
Okay, well, they're coming. Psalms 100 says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. And that's what we're doing tonight, right? Okay. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth for all generations.
Amen.
And this is a new type of generation these days. And we're still going to stay in here. We're still going to praise the Lord. And we're still going to worship. Okay? All right. Sing along with the ladies, okay, if you know these. Thank you. We're so glad to have Jeremy here with us tonight. Worship the Lord with him.
Oh, I guess I should get my lyrics. That might help me just a little bit.
It might.
I was thinking about what I was going to say to everybody before I sang this, Mary. Mary does such a great job putting all these songs together and putting this whole thing together, doesn't she? Can we just give her a big hand?
Thank you.
Tell you what, so much goes into it that none of us really know, but I think it was so appropriate that you put this song up towards the front, because I think any of us that are worshiping tonight, any of us that are singing or playing an instrument, we really could all adopt a song, because it's a song that just says to the Lord, it's almost a love song to Him. You know, when I was about 12 years old, this was the first song that I seriously sang in church. And so this has a lot of sentimental value to me. Any of you remember a group called the Imperials? Yeah. And it was a song by the Imperials, and it's called One More Song for You.
When I asked, no one knew, till I found the answer in you. So as long as there is time and one breath left in me, there will always be one more song for you. And as long as there is room, one more voice in praise, and indeed, for a word of love and truth, to help my brother through, there'll be one more song for you. Love is in the air around me, hope abounds everywhere. Living life in the arms of Jesus, learning how to really care. Every day life is filled with purpose, all the old is made new. And I know I owe it all to you. So as long as there is time and one breath left in me, there will always be one more song for you. And as long as there is room for one more voice in praise, and a need for a word of love and truth, to help my brother through, there'll be one more song for you. You, Lord, we give you glory.
one more song for you. We lift you up tonight with every song that's sung, with everything we do. There will always be one more song for you. We praise your name, we lift you up, we glorify your holiness. Oh God, there will always be one more song for you.
Well, we had a CD, and it stayed home. Danny said, why can't we just sing this like normal? He had some other words to describe it, and we said, okay. So we're unplugged. Our scripture is 1 Corinthians 7:23. You were bought with a price, and that's because of Calvary. Thank you, Jesus. I think you call this technical difficulties.
You have to put up real quick.
It's not in the sound booth. Okay.
Years I spent in vanity and pride, caring not my Lord was crucified. Knowing not it was for me he died on Calvary. Mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied to me. There my burdened soul found liberty. My sin I learned, then I trembled at the law I spurned, till my guilty soul imploring turned to Calvary. Mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied to to me there.
mercy there was great, and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied to me. There my burdened soul found liberty.
How many of you can say you've been to Calvary? We've been to Calvary because we've seen the Lord through His Word, haven't we? Tonight's song, I've Been to Calvary. I've been to Calvary through the witness of His Word. Each day at Calvary, what a thrill of love divine, just to know that the Savior is mine. I walk the Calvary road where Jesus trod. I saw Him hanging there, the Son of God. With tear-stained eyes I knelt and prayed, Jesus, hear my plea. Oh, praise the Lord, I'm glad I've been to Calvary. I've been to Calvary. I can say I've seen the Lord. I've been to Calvary through the witness of His Word. Each day at Calvary, what a thrill of love divine, just to know that the Savior is mine. I've been to Calvary. I can say I've seen the Lord. I've been to Calvary through the witness of His Word. Each day at Calvary, what a thrill of love divine, just to think, just to feel, just to know that the Savior is mine.
Thank you.
My paper's not marked.
I contracted rheumatoid arthritis, and the doctor said it's a good thing you got it now because when you die, you won't be so bad. That's what they said. Didn't sound like good news to me, so I made up my mind I was going to get prayed for. Well, to make the story short, I asked a man that was in the leadership, I said, I want you to pray for me, but wait, I said, I got to stake my faith. And I said, then you can pray. And I said, my faith is not in the doctors or the medicines, though they can treat, that's all they can do. I said, but my faith is in Jesus Christ and the cross. And the Lord spoke through him almost immediately. and said, they've spoken words of death and dying over you, but today I speak words of life, and it's gone. Yes. Amen. It's gone. So I want to sing The Anchor Holds, because my anchor is holding. Hallelujah.
Through the long I tell you what, God is in this house tonight. Praise the Lord. Well, I brought words. How many are glad for the family of God? Amen. The body of Christ. If you're not in one, you need to be. Hallelujah. But we're going to change things a little bit. I brought words. It doesn't mean I'll look at them. And I'm so teary that I've already had to clean my glasses once. So here we are. Hallelujah Square. And this man right here, some years ago, was healed of rheumatoid arthritis. Hallelujah. He had it bad.
Amen.
He was a young man, and God healed him.
Yes, thank
And he's
you.
Healed today. Hallelujah. Can you give me a little more voice? Just a little bit. And hit our song. Here we go. Hallelujah Square. These are with our girls, Carla and Cindy. I can't get them to come, but I brought them with me on a CD. Hallelujah. I saw a blind man tapping along, losing his way as he passed through the throng. Tears filled my eyes. I said, friend, you can't see. With a smile on his face, he replied to me, I'll see all my friends in Hallelujah Square.
Not be a cripple like me either. Praise the Lord. I want to give a real short report on Clint. How many of you miss Clint and Marvell? Yeah, well, I wanted to share with you about Clint. I know they would have liked to have been here, but he couldn't get his apron untied in time to get ready.
Claudine will tell him you said that.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Well, so much for that. Without the valleys, we couldn't have any mountaintops. Think of that. I've been through a few valleys myself. And because of God's love, His love, I stand before you today. And you stand or sit in front of us. The love of God. Hallelujah. The love of God is greater far than tongue or pen could ever tell. It goes beyond the highest star and reaches to the lowest hell. The guilty pair second verse. Someone has said that we like to sing in Pentecostal circles the first and the last verse, and sometimes leave the middle verses out. Sometimes they're the best. The meaning of those may minister to your heart. I trust it will. When horror times shall pass away, and earthly thrones and kingdoms fall, and they surely will. When men who hear refuse to pray, there'll come a time they will, on rocks and mountains fall. Think of that. God's love so sure shall still endure, all measureless and strong. It shall forevermore, forevermore endure the saints and angels' song. Oh, love of God, how rich, how pure, how measureless and strong. It shall forevermore endure the saints and angels' song. Now, could we think the ocean fill, and were the skies of parchment made, were every stalk on earth a quill, and every man a scribe by trade, to write the love of God above would drain the entire ocean, would drain it dry.
Thank you, Jesus.
Give him a mic. Thank you, Bill.
Do any of you here know of or remember Catherine Kuhlman? Let me see your hand. I lived in Pittsburgh when her ministry was there in a cathedral that was a block wide. It was a Presbyterian cathedral, and the pastor there, Dr. James Lamont, very conservative man, did not like women preachers, and Catherine Kuhlman was a Presbyterian minister. He reluctantly allowed her to hold her meetings there, and it wasn't long before he changed his mind about what was going on in those meetings. I would pass that cathedral, walk by it on my lunch hour. I worked right downtown. You could feel the presence and the power of God coming out of those doors. People would line up at 3 o'clock in the morning around a city block to get in there when the doors opened at 6. And sometimes her meetings would go till 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Thousands of people healed. Do you know what the key component was to that marvelous ministry? People came expecting. And when they expected the power and presence of God and believed it was going to be there, it was. When God's people humble themselves to call on Jesus and look to heaven, expecting as they pray, get a feeling something good is going to happen. And it can happen in these meetings also, where your hair stands up on your arms because of the power and the presence of God in our meetings. I feel like something good is about to happen. I feel like something good is about to happen. I just feel like something good is on its way. He has promised that he'd open all of heaven. And brother, it could happen any day. When God's people humble themselves, and look to heaven expecting as they pray, I just feel like something good is about to happen. And brother, this could be that very day. I have learned all that happened just to praise him, for I know he's working all things for my good. Every tear I shed is worth all the investment. I know he'll see me through, he said he would. He has promised eye nor ear can hardly fathom all the things he has in store for. Church, this could be that very day.
Isn't it fun? We can feel the presence of the Lord, and we can have just fun and good music, and we can clap and whatever. Okay?
Well, I'm not Faye, in case some of you might have that outline for tonight. But I told Mary that I would be her backup tonight, so Faye couldn't make it. And this song you've heard before, I'm sure. But, you know, I'm so glad that I can be a part of a great church that doesn't enclose just one denomination, but a church that involves all of God's people. One of these days, we're going to all come together, aren't we? And we'll be worshiping over there together. The blood-bought church. They shall lift up their voice, they shall sing for joy, they shall cry aloud and be free. They shall glorify the name of the Lord. It's the blood-bought, the church, the redeemed. Oh, we are in that army of the Lord, and we've been washed in the blood, and we are going forth. There is nothing that can harm this mighty moving force. With a shout of praise, a two-edged sword, every stronghold of bondage must fall beneath our feet. Every prisoner held captive must be free. Church, the redeemed. Oh, pick up your harp, O Zion of the Lord. Let the earth ring forth with his praise. All his children rejoice from the islands of the sea. It's the blood-bought, the church, the redeemed. And we are in that army of the Lord, and we've been washed in the blood. Our feet, every prisoner held captive.
Thank you, Lou.
Down from on high and took hold of me. He drew me out of deep waters when he reached down his hand for me.
Show me that I could be free.
bright memories to me. I remember as a little girl, we were in the parsonage one time, and there was a man came over. I don't remember if he was really sick. I'm sure my sister could tell me here, but or if he was really drunk. But all I remember is that he ended up singing that song, and the Lord gloriously saved him. And it was a good time that night at our house.
It's not going to stay, Mark, so let it go down. Huh? Let it go down. It's fine.
It's a comedy.
They say sometimes you whistle, sometimes you make a song. Right now, I'm losing breath. Stood on the stage night after night, reminding myself it'll be alright. Right now, I just can't. It's easy to sing when there's nothing to bring. But what will I say when I'm held to the flame? I got you right now. Well, I know you're. But even if you don't, my heart's in you alone. They say it all takes a little faith to move a mountain. Good thing, little faith is all I have right now. But God meant to choose, the mountains are movable. Give me the strength to be able to say it is well. Mine is so well. I know you're able, and I know you can. Save through the fire, you're my hand. But even if you don't, my heart's in you alone. I know the sorrow, and I know the hurt, but I'll go away. You just say the word, but even. Don't.
Getting rain.
Oh my goodness, is that an alarm?
Yeah, I think we're getting some weather.
He's been faithful.
We should celebrate.
And it is well with my soul. I've just met some people that have been coming to our church for a while, and we talked to him the other Sunday night. He played this for us, and I just asked him if he'd play it for us tonight. He plays a harmonica and a trombone, so they're going to be joining us. I'm hoping, right? We're having all kinds of fun up here. Wish you could hear them. No, you don't.
When I see Jesus and look on his face, want to say to the lady back there at the sound booth, she's doing a great job.
Amen.
Go ahead and strike up my band. I ask my mother, how much do you love me? Then she threw her arms wide open for my little eyes to see. Then she told me of on a hill so far away. When I heard how much he loved me, my life has never been the same. I love you this much. Then he opened his arms and died for me. Arms open wide, my Savior cried, I love you this much. Many times we've heard the story, we've memorized John 3:16, but sometimes we take for granted how he died for you and me. When my heart, it should be thankful for the price he paid for my sin. Just take me back to Calvary.
Thank you, Jesus. Power in His name. Thank you.
Thank you.
when I was 20 years old, I was lifting weights and hurt my back. Too inflated. The player is well with my soul. I'd like to join you.
Tell me a few good ones. Yes, sir. About when God came through.
Hallelujah.
right? Amen. About that time you didn't have the food, but then you got to eat. That time you didn't feel like you were going to make it through the night, but you made it to the next day. The enemy has this way of fooling us sometimes, and he'll tie us up and he'll chain us up. And the good news is that we serve a mighty, wonderful, powerful God that can break the chains that the enemy puts upon us. And tonight, that's what I want to sing about. And you just worship the Lord with me, because I know you've been through it. You've been walking the same old road for miles and miles. If you've been hearing the same old voice, tell the same old lies. If you're trying to fill the same old holes inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. We've all run to things we know that just ain't right. And there's a better life. There's a better life. If you've got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom for saving, he's an ever-saving savior. You got chains, he's a chain breaker. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. Testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. You got faith. If you feel lost, he's a waymaker. If you need freedom for saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. If you need freedom for saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. You're worthy, Lord, you're worthy, Lord. Thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord.
Just better go pick up my guitar.